Hello and welcome back to Excelsive. You must be aware of the new thing in the market these days, AI. You must have seen adverts of AI in nearly everything. Products, services, content, you name it. It seems AI is here to stay. Most of you might have also used ChatGPT at least once or twice. At least my friends who range from content writers to programmers don't only use it nearly every day, but they swear by the effectiveness of ChatGPT and similar models. Microsoft had recently announced AI in Office products as well. But as far as I know, it's only available with Microsoft 365 and that too, the Enterprise Edition. So most of us are missing out on that. But I came across an add-on that could show you what you can do when you combine ChatGPT with Excel. Supercharge your Excel game is what you can do. So, since this is an add-on, we'll have to install it in Excel. Open up a new file. Under Home tab, go to Add-ons. If you don't find it there, go to More Add-ons. Wait for it to load and in the search box here, type ChatGPT. And we are interested in this one. ChatGPT for Excel. Developer's name is Apps Do Wonders. At this point, let me clarify, they have not sponsored this video in any way and I'm not affiliated with them in any manner or form. Now that we've got that out of the way, let's click on Add here. We get to this window, I'm clicking on Continue, give it a moment to install, and here we have it ready to go. As you can see, this one is a free trial and it gives me 50 AI calls, which I'm guessing are like 50 questions or prompts I can trouble ChatGPT with. So let's begin. This add-on acts as a function, meaning you can use it in formulas. All you have to do is, just like you write any other formula, is equal to, and then type AI. And you will see all these options to choose from. We'll quickly check the easy ones first. This one is just like giving a prompt to ChatGPT and expecting a result. Only difference is you can do that in Excel. Like you ask in ChatGPT, what is the capital of the UK? And it'll give you a response, London. But that's pretty simple and objective. Let's try it with something a little more descriptive. I have a task here, to write an application to my manager for 2 weeks' leave. But I've thrown in an already applied bit in there too, to make it a bit more interesting. Let's write a formula here, AI.Ask. And for prompt, let's select this cell. It'll show you busy for a moment and here we have a detailed application as I required. It even has placeholders where I can fill my manager's name, start and end date for my leave, reason for the leave, and even says that all necessary steps have been taken for smooth functioning at the office in my absence. Pretty decent application if you ask. You can also use this to write short passages for your resume, your social media posts and whatnot. But you're not going to use this function for writing an application in Excel. You would use some word processing software like Word to do that. So what will be a better use for this function in Excel? Let's see. I can't tell you how many times I'm stuck at a problem in Excel and can't figure out which formula to start with. Earlier, I have used Google to give me a jump start. And although Google reigns supreme when it comes to search, but most of the time it lacks the understanding of my search term. That issue is handled by ChatGPT in a much better way. If I am to search on Google, which formula to use so I can find what day it was on a given date? It shows me a link to a page to use the day function, which is not what I want. But let's try the same question word for word in a ChatGPT extension. We are again going to use the AI.Ask function. And here we have our result. Right on the money, it tells us to use the text function instead and that is the right formula if you want to know the day of a certain date. By the way, I have a detailed video about the text function. You can check it. It's a pretty versatile function. I'll leave the link in the description. You must have extracted data like phone numbers, email addresses, city, country, etc. from multiple cells. Text before, text after and multiple other functions can help you do that. But only if your data follows a particular format throughout. For instance, here we have a list of phone numbers, but before that we have text, colon, and space. And all the fields here have the same format, so it's easy. we'll use text after function here. Text after, our text is here and our delimiter is colon and a space in double quotes. Press enter and done. Drag the formula down and you're good to go. But what if we have our data somewhat like this? No particular format and no fixed data to extract. From the first two, we have to extract phone numbers, then email addresses from the next two, then the city and country from the last one. How do you write something that works in all these cases? Here, we are going to use the AI.Extract. AI.Extract, our value is here, and what we need to extract is in here, and that's all. We have told ChatGPT we need to extract phone numbers from this text, and here we have it. Now let's copy this formula down and see if it works for email addresses and city, etc. as well. And it surely does. That's something that is indispensable. Next up is AI.Fill function. We have our data here, which is partially filled, and we have to find the country and currency of the remaining cities. To tell you the truth, apart from Tokyo and maybe Helsinki, I don't think I've ever heard about the other two, let alone know about what currency they use. Let's check with our AI.Fill function. I'm sure it knows better than I do. For our example, we'll select all these cells. This gives a sort of idea to ChatGPT of what we are looking for. Then for partial, we select this bit here, which we need filled. And a couple of moments later, we have our data. You might have noticed that I'm being a bit stingy with my examples in this video, and that is because I get only 50 tries with the free trial of this add-on. I have used some in preparation for this video and had to save some for the actual recording. As you can see, I only have these many left. This one can be a lifesaver if you have the same word or sentence to translate in many languages, or even if you have a list of words and all of them have to be translated to different languages. Either ways, this formula can save you a lot of time. In our example here, I have a simple sentence here in English, of course, and I have a drop-down here which has Spanish, French, and German as the languages. The idea is to change this English sentence into these languages. You can have the same thing copied and mentioned one language each, it will work the same. So let's start with our formula. We start with AI, then choose Translate. And for value, we choose our English sentence, and for language, we select a drop-down. And lo and behold, here we have our sentence translated. This will work wonders to people who are learning a foreign language or work in multinational corporations and have to send an email or message out to offices around the world. This might look similar to our first example, AI.Ask, but it is way better than that. Here, we have a prompt to find the top 5 goal scorers in 2023. But we just don't need the names. We need their goals and the players' respective countries, and we want them in this table here. Let's try this here. Our prompt is this, our header are these three up here, and done. Here we have our data neatly provided in a table. Again, this is a small example, but if you have some project where you need data like countries, population, currency, region, and whatnot, this can be of great help. Just mention the prompt up top and headers as you would like your data to be, and job done. Well, I think I have covered the most important functions related to Excel in this video, but you can try on your own to find scenarios that fit your specific need in your work or personal project. I am pretty sure soon we will have AI capabilities built into Excel. As I said, it has already started, but at a premium. And once it's available for everyone to use, that's when we see people using it to do wonders. That's it for this video. I hope I was able to show you something of interest. Before you go, like, share, and subscribe. I'll see you in the next one. Until then, happy spreadsheeting.